Hi, this is Scott Garibay, and today I want to talk about Vivek Ramaswamy, and I want to talk about states and descriptors, and we're going to talk about the third state and the third descriptor, right, which is myth, okay? All right, so one, this is part of a playlist, you know, just see the link below. If you're coming into this, you got to watch the whole playlist in order. Sorry, I don't do this that often, but this is a little bit of a different piece of... This is a structure that you're going to need as we begin to move toward putting Vivek Ramaswamy into the presidency in 2024, right? And the reality is we're getting a lot of information in and we're giving information out. We need to talk about how the states that the informations are capturing and then the descriptors we need to speak about the states that we're talking about. Okay, so I've talked about truth. Truth is delivered through epic. Okay, I've talked about reality. Reality is delivered through narrative. We talk about reality through narrative. I want to talk about myth. 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 What? What are you talking about, Scott? Myth. All right. We need to create myth around Vivek Ramaswamy. Why? Well, I'm gonna give you three reasons. Okay. George Washington, Abraham Lincoln, Harriet Tubman. These are Americans that true Americans love, right? All true Americans love George Washington. All true Americans love Abraham Lincoln. All true Americans love Harriet Tubman. But these Americans are so important to us as Americans. Excuse me. They're so critical, right? It's so important to what we are and who we are and what we do, okay? That essentially, they now have myth attached to them. Okay, now what is myth? Are you saying, Scott? Are you saying that we should lie about Vivek Ramaswamy? Absolutely not. Okay, but the reality is there are people who come into the public circle, right? And we attach like truly, what's the best way to say this? We attach hyper goodwill to them, right? And we say, hey, let's not focus on any of the negatives of this person. Let's squeeze them for the good juice, right? And we're all going to drink that good juice, right? Like that's the issue, right? We want to focus on what they did well. And whatever they didn't do well, we chuck it, right? And we craft an illumination. We craft light around these people, right? And there is myth around George Washington. There is myth around Abraham Lincoln. There is myth around Harriet Tubman, right? And we need to go here with Vivek Ramaswamy. We need to be to lift him up into myth, right? The Mount Olympus, right? The Greeks told stories in myth. Beowulf, the Vikings told stories in myth, right? And they were saying, these are our heroes. This is where our hope lies, right? And they told these incredible, they expressed a journey, right? They attached their emotion. They attached their goodwill, right? And they spoke about someone with myth, right? And so, you know, what are the myths we can start to attach to Vivek Ramaswamy, right? Well, and why would we do it, right? So, so one, let's talk about some myth that we can begin with Vivek Ramaswamy, right? And honestly, the myth that I am embracing now, that I am crafting in my own heart, right, is I truly believe Vivek Ramaswamy will be the first Indian American president, right? But if the Republicans put in a person of color, I truly believe it will be the end of prejudice systemically. The end. It will be the first time where America says, both, we are a two-party system, right? Third parties don't matter. By RFK Jr., that was cute, right? Nobody cares, right? We are a two-party system. The Democrats have proven, right, that they love all of humanity, no matter what their color. no matter what their origin, no matter what their ancestry, no matter what their lineage, no matter what their heritage. But the Republicans have not done this. It's all talk and no walk, right? And the Republicans say they're against that. They say they're for meritocracy, right? But the reality is their actions have shown hyper prejudice, right? Only ward cleavers, right? And they're behind the Democrats now. And Republicans don't like to be behind, right? They're merit-based, right? Metrics-based, right? They're supposed to put up, right? And they can, strong, silent types, right? But if you can't do, then you don't deserve the credit, right? And the reality is right now, Republicans stand for hyper-prejudice, right? But if Vivek Ramaswamy is elected, this America's systemic problem of prejudice will be dead. We will have lanced it in the heart. We have slain the dragon with a dragon lance that is Vivek Ramaswamy. That's what I mean by myth, right? And why would we do this? Well, Vivek Ramaswamy is an incredibly smart person. He's an incredibly joyful person. He's an incredibly kind person. He's an incredibly tolerant person. He's an incredibly intelligent person. But he can be more. He could be the greatest hope of the 21st century. He could be the death of systemic prejudice in America. Right? It's myth. And we imbue him with power. We imbue him with value. We say to Vivek, you are more than human. And we have done this, right? George Washington is more than human now, right? Abraham Lincoln is more than human now, right? Harriet Tubman is more than human. They are heroes, right? The Greeks believed in heroes from Mount Olympus. We believe in heroes who were born on this precious soil, right? And they are heroes, right? And with their legacy, they slay villains even today, right? It is important. This is where we are going. This is where we are heading, right? We must imbue Vivek Ramaswamy with myth. Not lies, but pure emotion, pure hope, pure joy. We make him more than human. We decide the value of a thing. Right now, Bitcoin is $26,000. It's a stupid string of numbers. And it's worth 13 times more than an American gold eagle. We determine value on everything. And we will imbue Vivek Ramaswamy with myth.